Hello viewers, welcome to my channel Cook with Reena. It's always a pleasure to welcome my regular visitors and very warm welcome to my new visitors. Cook with Reena is a one-stop destination where you can find varieties of recipes across India and some global cuisines also. So please do visit my channel, go through the videos. And these are very easy to do recipes, you can easily adopt it. I'm sure you will love the recipes, and after watching the videos, please like, share and leave your comments also. And please do subscribe my channel Cook with Reena, and you will find many interesting things over here. So viewers, it's a lovely day. And I'm going to do something interesting. So let's get started. So viewers, for fish in yogurt sauce, your yogurt curry, we call it doi mach. We'll require first of all mach, that is fish. I have taken here rohu fish. You can take katla or sea bass, that is Kolkata bhetki, or singhara fish. If you want, you can take that. And I have just put salt and turmeric. You have to marinate it with salt and turmeric only, nothing else. And shallow fried in very little oil. And then if it is curd sauce, that means you need to have the curd. And here it is 1 cup of curd. And few cashew nuts, and here are some of the, these are garam masalas, that is green cardamom, this is long, and this is cinnamon stick, and some grated ginger. And other than this, you require few spices like jeera powder, that is cumin powder, turmeric powder, little bit of coriander powder, and red chili powder for color, and some whole red chili I will use because unfortunately I don't have any green chili today. It is essential part, green chili. But you know, during lockdown you cannot just go to the market and fetch anything. We have to think twice, and with great precautions we have to do so. I have omitted this, but if you have green chili, please do use it. And one bay leaf I'll use. So let's start. The kadai is hot. I am putting oil. We have to shallow fry the fish. You don't need to brown the fish. You just have to, it will change its color, and you flip it. You know, few people make without tying it, but we like it little slightly tied, that's why I am doing it. So you can see this much frying is enough. I am switching off the oven. So preparing the yogurt sauce. So here is the yogurt. I have whipped it. I have added the whole red chilies and the bay leaf, and to this I am adding little flour. This is so that the curd doesn't curdles. When it is heated, we have seen that when we make any curry with curd, we keep stirring it so that it does not breaks. So but it will be put in the steam, so just to save it from curdling, I am using the flour. Any flour you can use. I am making it today, no onion garlic, so I have not used onion also. To this I am adding garam masala, that is red green cardamom and cinnamon sticks, and I'll add the ginger paste next. Now the other masalas, that is cumin powder, little bit, 1 teaspoon, 1 teaspoon ginger, and this coriander powder is just optional. I'm using it, but it is not compulsory. And now the red chili powder. If you put green chilies, you know, I don't generally use red chili powder. This will make the sauce little reddish, but if you do with only green chili, it remains whitish. So I have to whip it now nicely. Mix everything together and add salt to it. Remember, there is salt in fish also. Accordingly, you have to put. I have put 1.5 teaspoon of salt. Now mix it well. To this, add mustard oil generously. Three tablespoons I have already added. Now what I'll do, there is some residue oil in the fried fish also, that will also go in it. Just combine it well, and I'll keep this marinated for 15 minutes. Then I'll put it in the steam. It will be cooked in steam. And I am adding another thing which traditionally is not added, but since to make it little colorful, I'm adding. I have some cherry tomatoes, so I am adding that. And to this I'll add some cashews also. If nuts, you are open to add whatever nuts you want. If you want little sweetness in the curry, so you can add some kishmish also, raisin. So now this will, I'll cover it and keep it for 15 minutes before putting it in the steamer. Few add sugar powder also to balance the sourness of curd. It is just your choice whether you want to use it or not. It is not compulsory. So it has been marinating for 15 minutes. Now I shall put it in the steamer. I'll show you how. So this is my steamer. I have put in water at the bottom. Now I am putting this. I have covered it with silver foil. If you have a tight lid, that is better. And place it here. Cover. And at least for 20 minutes you have to cook it, for 20 minutes. So let it get, it will be cooked in the steam. I'll see you after 20 minutes. So the fish bowl is out from the steamer. Let us see. Wow, just look at this. It's so beautiful. So nicely cooked everything. So viewers, hope you have liked the recipe. Please like my video, and don't forget to subscribe. click on the bell icon beside it and get notification of all my new uploads. Thank you so much. Shall see you with another recipe. And of course, I'll serve it nicely and then show come back again. So viewers, you can serve this fish like this. Isn't it looking so attractive? Your guest will be delighted, even your family members. Serve it with hot steamed rice.